This show was first broadcast on Free FM 89.0, Hamilton, New Zealand's community access radio station. For more information on our station and the wide range of programs, visit freefm.org.nz.
Hey, Dad.
Johnny, can you help me with this iPhone?
Oh, Dad, just go to UB.
UB, Hamilton's only dedicated Apple authorized reseller and service provider for all your Apple needs, including iPads, iPhones, portables, and desktops. Come talk to the experts at UB, Te Awa at the base. To keep up to date with the latest news and announcements, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter at UBNZ, or head into store so we can help you be UB, the best you can be.
And now, hashtag Radio NZ.
Welcome to hashtag Radio. I'm Fid McAwesome.
I'm Chris McAwesome.
And I'm V8 Maddie.
And on this week's uncultured roundup of social media, web, tech, and gaming, we have a heap of stuff. A phone battery that's going to last you more than a day on a smartphone.
I say bull.
You
crap.
Say bull?
Bull pucky.
We've also got a heap of gaming stuff this week.
Yep. As per usual, there's a lot of gaming stuff going on. A little bit of Apple news. And the long overdue return of App of the Week.
Wow.
Oh, it's been a while. It's been a while.
It's Do we have a decent
app of the
app?
Year, I think, this time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But it's a good one.
It's a good one.
But we start off the week every week with Carice McAwesome and the news.
And now the news with Carice McAwesome.
And hitting the news this week, Microsoft CEO made a blunder earlier this week by suggesting women shouldn't ask for pay rises, but should instead trust the system and rely on karma to get what they deserve.
Rely on karma.
Yeah. Microsoft CEO later apologized, but by then it was too late. Microsoft board are now looking at the gender pay gap and the male culture in the company. While the comment is definitely a reflection of the industry's attitude towards women, it comes as a bit of a blessing in disguise, as it's highly unlikely the board would have investigated its pay differences.
Yeah, now, is karma considered a bargaining tool?
I don't know. I wonder how negotiations go.
Oh, yeah. If they dress nice and give them a little wink from time to time, they'll be fine.
So that's good karma.
That's good karma.
What goes around comes around, isn't it?
I wonder if they have karma points.
I don't know how karma works.
Like when you go for employee kind of evaluations...
We need a karma app.
Yeah.
We need a karma app. We could build them one.
Someone at Microsoft should develop one.
Yeah. Today, Snapchat blamed third-party software apps for possible security lapses that allowed a file containing 100,000 Snapchat photos collated by hackers who are preparing to publish them online tomorrow.
That's a heap of doodle shots.
Yeah. Snapchat have said their servers haven't been breached, but rather that it's third-party apps that have been downloaded by users are to blame for the privacy breaches.
And they actually have in their terms and conditions, that you shouldn't be using third parties.
Yeah. Poor people.
Yeah.
And all those Snapchats that they thought had disappeared haven't.
Big bag of dicks.
Yeah. Baidu Inc.
Baidu. Yep.
Yeah, is China's biggest search engine. Is working on an operating system for a bicycle that will enable users to improve their workouts. Using sensors and artificial intelligence, the bike will feature an onboard display that responds to voice commands. It will monitor factors such as heart rate, calories burnt, traffic, and mapping data.
Not really the sort of rideable tech I had in mind when I was envisioning rideable tech.
I'm a little bit worried about what you were envisioning for rival tech.
Most of that stuff can be done now with phones and
smartwatches and stuff. Yeah.
It's like they've moved what was in a car into a bike, and then added watch apps.
Taking it old school.
Yeah. If you haven't already heard, the fake Emma Watson nude video circulating around the web is actually malware. So if you think someone has cared enough to send you a bit of free porn, they haven't. If it's too good to be true, then it's too good to be true. So don't let naked strangers infect you. Hashtag, that's a rule to live by.
That is a good rule to live by.
Yes. If you want free porn, don't rely on your friends.
Google's Nexus 9 is rumoured to be unveiled next week. Reportedly built by HTC, the price rumours have it at around $399 USD. Other rumours also include the Google is working on the release of a new large screen smartphone as well. A new survey conducted by Pepper Jeffrey has the top three spots for teenagers as Instagram, Twitter and then Facebook, with Pinterest and Tumblr coming in fourth and fifth. There's been a noticeable decline in Facebook. Not that Facebook's really concerned because they own Instagram.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, good point.
Yeah. Oh, dear, we're not number one anymore. It's that other thing we own.
Yeah. Oh. And finally, Google Maps, dedicated to giving people their street views. In order to collect images of Abu Dhabi desert, Google adopted a low-tech method by strapping the camera to a camel. No reports yet as to how much the camel got paid, but it's highly likely, considering it's Google and it's a tech company, that the camel was a male.
Camel cam.
Yes. There's
lots of camel toe shots.
Yeah, don't Google search that.
And is that the news?
It's the news.
Yeah, awesome. There's also another release coming up very shortly that I think we should talk about a bit later on in the show. Do some speculation.
About what?
Ooh, another big release.
No, your
device, tech device.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So the rumour that Google have got a smartphone.
No, not that one. It's another one. Another company.
Automated camels.
Yeah. Another company is doing a big release very shortly.
Ooh.
Yeah. And also, talking about release, we've got some release dates of some upcoming games and gaming hardware later in the show.
Yay.
Yeah. Big titles, big titles. One in particular that I'm really excited about, and I got the email with the date, and I was like...
Oh, Lord, it's not a wrestling one, is it?
No, it's not a wrestling one.
Thankfully.
It's a fighting one. But anyway, we've still got heaps coming up in the show. Make sure you stick around. And we are brought to you by Yubi. You can check them out at Tiawa The Base, or follow them on Twitter at UbiNZ, or look up Yubi on Facebook and give them a like.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
It does. First track coming up. Now, this one here is related to your bit of news about Snapchat.
It's a Snapchat song.
Nice.
Kind of.
Kind of. This one's Let Me Take a Selfie.
Oh, Lord.
When Jason's at the table, I kept on seeing him look at me while he's with that other girl. Do you think he was just doing that to make me jealous? Because he was totally texting me all night last night, and I don't know if it's a booty call or not. So, like, what do you think? Did you think that girl was pretty? How did that girl even get in here? Do you see her? She's so short, and that dress is so tacky. Who wears cheetah? Why is the DJ keep on playing Summertime Sadness? After we get out of the bathroom, can we go smoke a cigarette? I really need one. But first, let me take a selfie. Model. She definitely bought all her Instagram followers. Who goes out on Mondays? Okay, let's go take some shots. Oh no, I feel like I'm gonna throw up. Oh wait, never mind, I'm fine. Let's go dance. There's no vodka at this table. Do you know anyone else here? Oh my god, Jason just texted me. Should I go home with him? I guess I'd take a good selfie. Let me take a selfie.
as Protestants and Catholics will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Want more of that free FM feeling? Find it anytime, online, on our website, freefm.org.nz. Get the lowdown on all your favourite free FM shows and their hosts. Plus, discover our latest podcast picks. You can even learn about how you, yes you, can get on air with Free FM, because this is real community radio.
Hashtag Radio NZ.
You are back with Hashtag, brought to you by UB. You can check them out at Tiawa The Base, follow them on Twitter at UBNZ, and check out all of their Apple stuff on their website at UB.com.
I'd only heard a little bit of that song.
Yeah?
I hadn't heard the whole thing.
Yeah.
It was pretty clubby.
It was pretty clubby.
We were getting a rave on in the studio today.
We just needed the glow sticks and the black light, and we would have been on.
Yeah, and some good looks.
Yeah.
And some booze.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Talking about UB, though. You're going to be able to possibly pop in there to buy a new device very shortly.
Ooh. Oh, what is this device?
The iPhone 6.
No, well, that's already there.
Oh, iPhone you're already 6 pop Plus. In.
You can, oh, that's going to be coming. We already know that's coming. But a new device they're getting ready to announce very
soon. The Apple Watch.
That's already been announced.
Oh.
Yeah. No. At the Recode event, which is going to be held at October the 16th, which is very close.
Yeah.
Apparently, we're going to get a new iPad announced.
No. Really?
Yep. Is it going to be an iPad Plus?
Well, a wee bit bigger.
And how flexible are they?
Yeah, size of a 20-inch screen.
But there's many speculations around at the moment what the design's going to be, whether it's going to go with the new iPhone design with the full alloy backs and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Whether they're going to include the...
Will it bend in your bag?
Possibly. The touch sensor, there's all sorts of rumours about what it's going to actually do and not going to do. And
I'm sure a lot of the things they say that it might do, it probably won't.
Yeah. Also, what I'm anticipating they'll announce as well is possibly a new Mac.
Yeah.
Because we haven't had a big Mac announcement for a while.
Mm. Whilst we're on Apple devices.
Yes.
The company that's been tasked with making their Sapphire screens.
Yes.
And camera lenses and stuff. GT Advanced Technologies.
Yes, mm-hmm. They're a part owner of them, aren't they?
No. Okay. So they're a Sapphire manufacturer.
Yeah.
And they've announced that they're going to close two plants in Arizona and Massachusetts, costing 890 people their jobs.
Ooh.
Wow. They have filed for bankruptcy in the U.S. bankruptcy court and asked to terminate the oppressive and burdensome contract with Apple. So apparently Apple have driven them into the ground.
So
with their
Apple are oppressive and...
And burdensome.
Oh, I wouldn't have thought that.
Really? Yeah. Are you being sarcastic?
I can't... Yeah.
So they've apparently been bleeding money, they say,
yeah,
after opening a plant with Apple last year, and now want to shut down the plant and end their relationship with Apple. And obviously going through bankruptcy because of it all.
I wonder then if the Sapphire screens are on the new iPad that's supposed to be.
Well,
in,
I thought that they'd already said that Sapphire was going to be used on the watches.
Yeah, they use Sapphire now for the Touch ID sensor on some camera lenses.
Mm-hmm.
And they were planning on using it for the Apple Watch face.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
And I believe they do have other suppliers, but these guys were the main one.
Yeah.
So there's now also speculation that with this deal going down the gurgler that the Apple Watches won't be able to be made or produced in quantity as originally planned as well.
Yeah, because overseas there's a Sapphire screen shortage, and Xiaomi has been buying up as many Sapphire screens as they can get their hands on.
Oh, Xiaomi.
Xiaomi. Your. Yeah.
And rumors have speculated then that Apple would be in trouble with their watches.
So they're buying up all the Sapphire stuff. Is that because they're coming up with a new phone themselves?
Xiaomi.
No. Their high-end phone.
Already uses it.
Yeah, already has a sapphire screen.
Ah, okay.
Mm.
And it's already in demand.
Yeah.
And they can't actually meet demand because of the lack of sapphire screens.
Yeah, wow.
So, yeah, I'm guessing Apple will be scrambling a bit to try and figure out what they're going to do now that these guys are trying to pull the pin.
Yeah. Yeah. I imagine so. Hey, talking about phones and stuff, though, what's the one thing that we have complained about for the last couple of years when it comes to smartphones, the one thing that we all want?
Battery. Longer battery life.
Matt?
Yes, battery life.
Battery life.
And price.
What if I told you that there was a phone coming out on the market that had up to 30 hours of battery time?
Is that using it?
Use.
30 hours use.
Yeah.
So, about 50 hours standby?
I'd say longer than that on standby.
True.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a couple of days, like.
Yeah, exactly, almost.
It's like what we want.
Exactly. Well, there is a company out there who is releasing a phone called the Droid Turbo.
Yeah.
And it is going to be released with a 3,900 milliamp hour battery.
That's insane.
It's huge.
Is it a smartphone?
It is a smartphone. Of course, with the name, it's going to be running Droid.
Android?
Yep, standard. Everything else about the phone is quite standard.
Yeah.
But then the one thing everybody wants...
is the battery.
It's a huge battery. It isn't the...
How heavy does it make it?
Those specs, I haven't got those in front of me. Mm. But it's not the most... it's not the biggest battery on the market. But the tech inside, they've managed to utilise that battery life better. Huawei with the Ascend Mate has a 4,050 milliamp hour battery, and the Lenovo P780 has a 4,000 milliamp battery. But
those don't last as long.
They don't last as long, yeah.
That's amazing. When will this be stolen by every other tech company and put into their phones?
Shortly, I'd say. This one, is it going to be exclusive in the States on Verizon? So there's no word yet about whether it's going to be released in New Zealand or anything, but there are places that you can go online to buy these things.
Yeah.
Yes, there are.
So, so it's going to be available very soon, and I'm excited. Finally, battery life.
Yeah.
I want that battery put into my LG G3.
Well, the cool thing about the G3 is it's expandable sort of thing. You can take the back off and put new things in it.
Mm.
Can you do that with yours, mate?
No, mine's a bit mine's a bit more iPhone-like.
Yeah.
Because you've got the Sony Xperia?
The Xperia Z2. So it's a bit of a sealed unit. The back doesn't come off.
Hey.
And how's your Windows phone doing?
I was just about to say, personal cell phone update here. My Nokia, which I've gone on about for the last almost a year.
Yeah.
Almost a year I've used this. I got it.
Your 42 megapixel
I got
camera?
It the week after the Xbox launch.
Yes.
When was that, Matt? November?
Apparently. Yeah. almost a year ago.
And so I've been using it and I've been going on about how much I love it. And I've got two problems with it now.
Yeah.
First problem came up about a month ago when my camera started squealing.
Yeah, but your camera is supposed to make funny noises. That's a
not
feature.
Not a squeal. So when I'm taking a video,
yeah,
like when you can hear it lightly when you're just taking a photo or something, it's just like... yeah, exactly.
Sounds like an old man dying.
But the thing is, you take a video with it and that subtle squeal that you hear when you're not taking a video is like really predominant over top of everything. Yeah, like
hey, just one other thing with batteries. I came across another battery-related device online today, and it's called the Pronto Battery Pack, and they're doing a Kickstarter at the moment. And what it is a, you know, a portable battery pack to charge your devices from.
Yeah.
Nothing new.
Nothing new. But this one works really fast.
Oh, like how fast?
Like, you can plug it into the wall socket to charge it up.
Yeah.
Right? Because it's all good having those things.
Yeah.
But then when you've used them, you have to charge them overnight, you know, and the convenience is gone. This one will charge in 5 minutes.
You're kidding me.
From zero to full.
Yeah.
How much storage is on there?
It's hang on, let me just find these specs. So it's got a 13,500 milliamp hour battery inside of it.
Wow.
Wow.
And what does that do? It gives us... Sorry.
This is great radio.
So it'll charge an iPhone basically 5 times.
Wow.
And it'll recharge in 5 minutes. It'll also charge your phone and stuff a lot faster as well because it uses the maximum transfer rate that it can for your device, which is similar to how it's set up to use the full voltage from the wall socket when it's plugged in to recharge it.
Yeah.
So there's going to be two of them, a bigger one and a smaller one, obviously. The bigger one will give you a lot more, the Pronto 12, it's called.
So is this out now or is it on Kickstarter?
It's on Kickstarter.
How many days left to go, do we know?
I'm not sure. I haven't checked how long it's got left to go.
Mm.
Exciting sounding device, though.
Yeah, well, there's the Pronto 5 and the Pronto 12. So the Pronto 12 also comes with an additional 12-volt lead that you can use to run any 12-volt device.
Jumpstart your car.
Oh, you're probably just about good.
Well, they're 12-volt, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Depends on whether there's enough oomph out of this device.
Well, you charge your battery.
Highly possible.
You could potentially charge your car battery with it.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
It is.
So that's cool.
Yeah.
Battery's doing fast stuff.
So there you go, Fid, for your Nokia Windows.
Yeah.
It would charge it quickly.
It would, if I was using it.
Yeah.
I've actually stopped using it this week.
Oh. Really?
Yeah, I stopped using it and I've gone back to Android. I'm on a really dumb Android. Well, not dumb Android, but it's a...
Older?
It's a mid-range one. I've gone down like
a heap of specs.
So it's
a not-so-smart smartphone?
No, it's a smartphone. It's just the camera's dumb. And
it's an average phone.
It doesn't have any internal memory. But the other problem is since I've been on Windows 8.1, which was released 2 weeks ago,
yes,
I found that I'm having to charge my phone at least 3 times a day.
See, and this is where the Pronto would come in handy.
It would have come in bloody handy if I was still using it.
Instead of waiting, how many hours or minutes do you have to wait for your phone to get charged?
About half an hour.
Yeah, it'd be done in 5 minutes, be 3 times a day.
Sweet at an event or something, eh? When your phone's dying a bit, you can just plug it in your bag for half an hour and you're mint.
Exactly.
Even for work.
Mm. Yeah, I got so frustrated though with the Nokia. Like, the camera thing was the first thing that annoyed me. But having to charge my phone 3 times a day,
yeah, that's ridiculous.
It was, yeah, it was crazy. So I got frustrated with it the other day, pulled my SIM card out, whacked it into one of these phones and back on Android.
I still get more than a full day on my phone.
Yeah, so do you with the G3, eh?
Not at the moment because Fid turned on my health app on my phone, on my LG.
Why do you need the health app running, Fid?
I'm looking out for you.
You wanted to see how many steps I took at work.
Oh.
It wasn't many.
He's tracking you. He's seeing how far you go from work during the day.
Yeah.
And I found out, I've discovered that I'm lazier at home. I've done considerably less.
Over the weekend.
No, but today.
Oh. There's less distance yesterday to travel at home.
This is true.
Yeah, couch, fridge, bed, couch, fridge, bed.
Yeah, like yesterday I calculated I'd done like over 3,000 steps or something.
And because at work you got to make the most of being paid while you go to the toilet.
Yeah.
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 So, I mean, there's frequent trips to the bathrooms and back.
Yeah.
When you're on work time.
Yeah, and they're long bathroom breaks.
Oh, they are.
But today I think I've only done like 700.
Yeah. Holy crap.
I'm gonna turn that off. Not only because it's depressing, but two, it's using up all my battery.
Yeah. Anyway, I reckon we should come back and talk about some gaming stuff.
I think that's
a good idea. And we've still got an app of the week.
We do.
It's our periodic segment that you may remember from about a year ago that we used to do.
And I've got a PlayStation 4 Fez update.
Oh, Fez.
Fez.
All right, you're on hashtag we're brought to you by Ubi. Check them out online at ubi.com, on Twitter and on Facebook. And if you're around Hamilton, check them out at Te Awa The Base. This is hashtag.
Door. And you're sure, but you love them anyhow. Lost feelings of love, lost feelings of love that hover above me. Lost feelings of love, lost feelings of love that hover above me. The most drop by, 'cause they know they can find me here, and they claim to be held from me in chains, but come on, they're guilty as sin, my dear. I'm becoming a ghost, becoming a ghost, so nobody can know. Bones break through, but they hurt less as time goes on. And alone, I build my own home to be sure that nobody can touch me now.
iPhone. Oh, Dad, just go to UB.
UB, Hamilton's only dedicated Apple authorized reseller and service provider for all your Apple needs, including iPads, iPhones, portables, and desktops. Come talk to the experts at UB, Tiawa at the base. To keep up to date with the latest news and announcements, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter at UBNZ, or head into store so we can help you be UB, the best you can be.
#RadioNZ. Welcome back to Hashtag Radio. Thanks for turning the mic on there.
Not a problem.
Much appreciated. So, as I was saying, welcome back to Hashtag Radio. Fid's pushing buttons.
Yeah.
He is. But we're going to go back to something we haven't done for a long time, which is our app of the week.
Wow.
App of the week.
And there it is.
Oh, that's why he was pushing buttons.
That's yeah, he was trying to find that one we haven't used for so long.
Yeah, I had to blow the dust off the record, off the needles. Oh, no, off the needle and wipe down the record. And
yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So this week's app of the week.
Yes.
We're going to go with an iPad-specific one.
Okay.
Seeing as we were talking about iPads before.
Yep.
And if you need an iPad, you can go down to UB at Tiawa.
Yeah.
And they will hook you up.
They will.
Then once you've got your iPad, you can download Adobe Clip.
Adobe Clip?
Adobe Clip. It's a free video editing app. There are probably some apps out there that are a bit more user-friendly, but they cost a fair bit of money.
Yeah.
Adobe will happily provide you this for free.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Adobe is giving something away for free.
There's quite a lot of Adobe apps available for free.
Yeah, on iPad?
Yeah, Photoshop, They've got a Photoshop
app. There's Photoshop, there's Illustrator, there's...
Yeah.
Wow, really?
There's all sorts on there.
They're not as in-depth as the PC or Mac versions.
Yeah, well, naturally.
But you can do the basics on them.
Yeah.
They're fine.
So Clip is a version of Premiere, I'm guessing.
Basically, yeah. So you can do your video editing, put together little movies and stuff.
Wow.
It is limited functional... Is like Fid was saying,
yeah.
With the PC version and stuff is going to be a lot more in depth. But
if you were out on the go and you filmed something and you wanted to chuck an intro and some music on,
yeah, you can totally do that. And
wow.
It's probably a good way of getting the kids started as well.
Yeah,
they can shoot some movies with the iPad and edit them, and boom, you're away laughing.
Yeah.
Oh, nice of you to play on it.
Just briefly.
Yeah.
I'm not very clever with these things, so yeah. I need a bit more time.
Yeah. But, yeah.
But our illustrious hashtag TV producer, you'd...
I'm interested.
Yeah, you'd probably love it.
It'd be great. You could do it on, like, when you're out.
Yeah.
Film, sit down and do a quick edit.
I assume it would sync with the Creative Cloud as well.
Yeah, there's an Adobe Creative Cloud app, but with these Adobe apps, most of them now you're required to sign in with an Adobe ID.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you've already got a Creative Cloud account, you can just log straight in and you're off and laughing.
That'd be handy for us because we use the Adobe Creative Cloud for everything now.
Yeah.
Like literally everything. Yeah, we use it. We record our shows on it. All the pictures and stuff on our website are done on Photoshop or Illustrator.
Yeah.
Hashtag TV is done on Premiere, and now we can do videos on the go.
Yep. So the app also has some nice friendly guides, a lot like the iMovies app as well. It'll take you through the basics and show you how to create your own movies, do your basic video editing, adding fancy stuff.
Ooh.
With a few tricks. Also doing the audio, and there's your standard issue sharing functions as well, so you can share your movies. You can upload them to your Adobe Creative Cloud account.
That's fantastic.
Store them. So that's a cool one. A lot of people these days running around with iPad minis and stuff, so that'd be quite handy as well for making some home movies.
Look on your face, is it all?
So there we go. We finally revived App of the Week.
Yeah. If you have any suggestions for App of the Week for future episodes, tweet us at hashtag RadioNZ.
Yeah, we may or may not use them.
We may or not.
We do prefer free apps because everyone can jump on and have a go then.
Especially when a big company like Adobe release something for free.
I know. And, we use Adobe for all our audio and video stuff.
Yeah.
For hashtag me.co.nz.
Yep.
So, shout out to Adobe.
Yeah, we love them.
Yeah.
Awesome. Now, some gaming stuff.
Oh, my Fez update.
Tell us about Fez.
Okay, so last time I was at 81%.
What's Fez?
Fez is this weird little game. It originally started off as a PC game.
Oh, right, yes.
And
it's coming back to me now.
Yeah, it's on PlayStation 4.
Yes.
Now, and it's like that 16-bit that's like 3D. Real weird game. And last time I was at 81%.
Yeah.
So my update is I'm now at 84%.
Wow.
Yeah, and now I'm officially stuck.
Streaking ahead.
Yeah, I'm stuck. I have to, I've been Googling for the last week.
How to get past the bit you're on?
Yeah.
Do you want me to do it?
No, I want to do it. I'm stuck in this room full of doors that every time I go in one door, I come out
in the same room?
Yeah, into the same room.
Well, it sounds like you've been playing PT.
Really? Is that what PT's like?
Oh, PT, you just walk around in a big loop.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
it's creepy as shit.
I'm trying to look at walkthroughs, but they don't go that far.
So have you tried some way of identifying which doors you've tried?
Yes.
And you've been through all the doors?
Well, in my head, yes, but I think my process is wrong.
It must be one you haven't gone through if you're still coming back to the same place.
I know.
Have you tried walking through a door backwards to see if you wind up somewhere else?
I can't walk in backwards.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because if you're going forwards through the door and you come into the same room, if you went through it backwards, maybe you'll wind up somewhere else.
Oh, I get what you mean. I'm going to have to start my process. There's like 64 doors in there.
That's grasping at straws, but it's worth a go.
Yeah, I might have a go at that.
You can try spinning around and hopping on one foot as you go through the door.
Mm.
What have you been playing, Matt?
I'm still thrashing out Forza Horizon 2.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you still going on that?
Still going. Still going hard.
Oh.
I'm stockpiling a garage full of crappy old vehicles that I'll never drive that I keep getting given.
Yeah.
But having said that, the first DLC pack is available for download now. So if you have a car pass, season pass thingy, then that's included in that. But you can buy the pack separately.
What's in the pack?
In the pack, we've got the 2015 Jaguar F-Type R Coupe.
Ooh.
The 2014 Jeep Grand Cherokee SRT. The 2013 Renault Clio RS200. A 1988 Volkswagen Scirocco 16V. 1957 Maserati 300S and a 1988 BMW M5.
Hmm.
So those are the ones you can get in the current DLC. I think that 88 BMW M5 is going to actually be available for free for all players.
Oh, wow.
As a bit of a tease, I guess, to try and get you to buy the rest of the car pack.
Yeah.
So we're going to have to talk to our friends at Xbox New Zealand and see if they can hook us up with the car pack. Come on, guys.
Nice. What have you been playing, Fig?
I haven't.
You haven't?
Wow.
I haven't played anything for the last couple of weeks. I've been busy.
Is that your excuse?
No, I've been busy. I've been busy talking to game developers and stuff at events.
Oh.
Yeah, but same, and I'm 84% through Fez.
Yeah, no, I haven't played anything.
I've only got like one perk left to unlock on Horizon 2.
However,
really?
New PlayStation 4 games for free.
Okay.
Games for free.
Yep. This month's free games for PlayStation.
Oh, nice.
On the PlayStation 4, it's a game called Spelunky.
Oh, Spelunky.
Yeah. It is an indie game.
It sounds Russian.
I've heard of it.
Yeah. It's free. And it's available to download now.
What type of game is it?
It looks like it's a side-scrolling sort of two-dimensional game.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
To be honest, it's probably not the coolest PS4 game they've given away. So
a side-scrolling indie platformer.
Mm. Yep.
Cool.
On the PS Vita, there are two games available. Rainbow Moon, which just looks like a trip fest.
Someone was on E when they were developing
LCD.
LCD.
LSD. Too many TVs in your life.
Yeah. I think so.
Plix the Cat is also available.
Plix the Cat.
Yeah, and I know nothing about Plix the Cat. So.
Okay.
Well, you're a wealth of knowledge.
I know, right?
You've rattled off some titles and nothing
else. Well, this is where it gets cool. The two PS3 games this month that are free are both really good games.
Yes.
Dungeons & Dragons Chronicles of Mystara. So if you're a...
I thought you said they were really good games.
No, listen, okay. The next one is really good.
Okay.
It's not going to let you down. Batman Arkham Asylum. It's free.
Free
on PS3 for the next 24 days, 19 hours, 21 minutes and 20 seconds.
So you got a choice, Dungeons & Dragons.
Or Batman. Yeah.
Batman.
It depends on what sort of nerd
you
are.
You can't say Batman, you've got to say Batman.
Speaking of Batman.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The Lego movie was a big hit.
And they were going
to make a sequel, but they've actually pushed that aside for the moment and are apparently going to do a Lego Batman movie.
Really?
Because
from the
Batman
from that
was
band.
The best part of the Lego movie.
Yeah, he was.
And so he's going to get his own film.
Whoa.
I can't wait for the Batman.
I think I'm more excited than the kids will be.
Same. Same. So the director guy is one of the guys from, does a lot of the Robot Chicken stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. He was involved with the Lego movie and he's meant to be doing the next ones as well.
Oh, cool.
And there's also going to be a Ninja Lego movie.
Ninjago. Yeah.
But
well, there's already a Ninjago TV series. Do we need a movie as well?
I don't know. If there's money to be raked in, they'll go looking for it.
Hey, talking about nerdy movies, just before we jump back into some gaming.
Say nerdy or nudie?
Nerdy.
Okay.
Nerdy.
I'll listen
to this one's for the comic book nerds.
Yeah.
All right, so we're coming up in the next couple of years. We're going to finally see Batman versus Superman. Exciting stuff.
Now, if you say so, yeah.
This is exciting stuff. Now, Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Spider-Man, as we all know, is completely separate in the movie world because Sony own Spider-Man and Marvel own everything else.
Yep.
Yeah.
Now, they were making a third Spider-Man movie in the new reboot series.
Mm-hmm.
It has been canned.
Oh.
They were going to make two spin-offs from it, which was going to be the Sinister Six and a Venom movie. They've both been canned.
Oh.
Rumour has it they've all been canned because they're actually going to allow Spider-Man to join the Avengers.
No. Are you serious?
I'm serious. I'm serious. 100% serious that I can confirm that that is just a rumour.
That Spider-Man's going to be in the Avengers movie.
Yeah, but it's just things sort of do add up, the fact that they've cancelled all these big movies and...
Yeah. I still want to see the Deadpool movie. That's going to be...
That will be ace.
Ryan Reynolds.
I'm hoping they introduce Deadpool in the next Avengers movie.
Does that mean there'll be in Spider-Man in the Infinity? The Disney series? The games?
I assume he can be in Infinity.
Is that Disney?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So well, Disney own Marvel now.
So we can have a Star Wars Marvel crossover.
Yeah, we could potentially have Spider-Man versus Chewbacca.
Sounds like a death match.
It does.
Enjoy watching.
Yeah, we could be riffed by Mickey. Or Pooh Bear, because they own him now as well.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Disney, they own our childhood.
Disney and Google are taking over the planet.
Yeah. But yeah, back to some gaming.
Back to some gaming. What else have we got? Xbox One.
Yeah.
Sunset Overdrive's now available for pre-order.
Yeah, recommend that game highly. I don't have the Xbox One, but if I did, I would be pre-ordering that because I thoroughly enjoyed jamming on that at Digital Nations.
Fantastically fun and fast-paced game.
Yeah.
Lots of cool stuff going on.
It is the sort of game that you have to have a spin on it a few times before you got used to it, I'd say, because there is a lot going on.
There is a ton going on, yeah.
And change the controller layout.
Yes. Organise the controller so you know what you're doing.
Yep.
But if you pre-order that, there's a ton of free extras that you get. Some day one bonus items and stuff. There's a couple of bonus weapons that you'll get and stuff.
So will you be pre-ordering the day one, Matt?
Well, we know how I go with pre-ordering day one editions of things and it never works out. Yeah. So probably not.
I've got some release dates of some games that are highly anticipated games for the next year.
Highly anticipated.
Are we starting now?
Well, we could start this as a segment.
Yeah, whether or not they'll actually come out.
Okay, so I have here the...
Have a sweepstake on the original release dates.
Yeah. So these are the announced dates that... Some of these release dates haven't been formally announced, but we got an email with all of these dates from somewhere.
Okay.
Did we
find it on a bar stool?
Yes, there we go.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. So this is for EA, Ubisoft, Disney, WBIE, Turtle Beach and Five Star.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And Sega. Yep.
Yeah. Who are they?
They do all the sports games.
They used to make consoles once upon a time.
Oh.
Yeah. They're the ones who are bringing out the new Alien game, which is amazing. Okay. Lego Batman 3 Beyond Gotham is going to be available on the PS4, Xbox One, PS3, 360, Wii U, the 3DS, and PC.
Yep.
Release date November 4th, 2014. So that one there is coming out this year. Dying Light, which is on the PS3, PS4, 360, and Xbox One, is going to be released January 29th. Now, that one there is one that I would say may be pushed back.
You reckon?
Yep.
Which one?
Dying Light.
Dying Light.
Dying Light?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a big one. I should have read this list last because it's got my favourite game on there.
Okay.
I'm going to save that one for the last of this list.
Oh, Mario.
No.
Batman Arkham Knight.
Yes.
Which is the new one, which I think we're all looking forward to.
I'm dead keen on a bit of Batman.
This one here is only going to be on the next-gen consoles, on PS4 and Xbox One, and on the PC. And that is going to be released next year, 4th of June.
Wow, that's a while ago.
June.
Now, this one here hasn't been formally announced yet, so this is almost an exclusive.
Yes, go.
Mortal Kombat 10.
Yes, you have my attention.
Mortal Kombat 10 is going to be available.
Mortal Kombat X.
It is, technically, yeah.
Thanks,
Mortal Kombat X is going to be available on the PC, the PS3, the PS4, the 360, and the Xbox One.
Yes.
And it will be released next year. April the 16th.
That's my brother's birthday.
What game was it?
Mortal Kombat X.
So you can get me there for my birthday too.
Could do.
Because my birthday is just...
Or Chris's birthday.
Yeah.
Well, Chris's birthday is a few days before that.
I'm so excited.
Yep. Yay, we're getting games from Fed, Carice.
Well, you got T-shirts last year. Don't whinge.
Yeah.
Were we whinging?
No.
We were just getting excited.
I've been Mortal Kombat. I can't believe it, because it looks fabulous.
I know. It looks like the rebirth of...
So I want to play it.
When's The Crew coming out?
The Crew? Okay, I have got a date for The Crew. The Crew is December the 2nd this year.
So that's been pushed back to December the 2nd.
Yes. And I reckon it's going to get pushed back to January.
No, I think finally this will be the last date.
There's only so many times they can push it.
Yep. All right, Rocksmith 2014. Rocksmith 2014 on the PS4 and the Xbox One is going to be released on the 6th of November. Now, Far Cry is going to be released.
Far Cry 4.
Yeah, Far Cry 4, November 18th on all platforms.
Yes, it is.
Watch Dogs will be released.
Oh, that was very exciting. What? Watch Dogs.
Yeah. For the Wii U.
Yeah, Watch Dogs will be released for the Wii U November the 20th.
Awesome.
The Wii.
I know, right.
Wii U owners rejoice.
Yeah. Okay.
Wii U's sort of a punchline here on Hashtag. Assassin's Creed Unity and Assassin's Creed Rogue are both getting released on the same day.
What day would that be?
November 13th.
November the 13th, 2014.
Yep.
Now, that game has caused a lot of hoo-ha.
Oh, yeah. Tell me about the hoo-ha.
You've heard about the hoo-ha, Fid?
No. Actually,
with the resolution between the two consoles.
Ah.
So the dude came out and said they were going to lock it at 900 p with 30 frames per second.
Yeah.
To stop any issues between PS4 and Xbox One owners getting upset that one console's better than the other.
Yeah.
And that's caused absolute online havoc.
I was going to use a big word, but I don't know the big word.
Yeah.
Ferrari. Ferrari? Is that it?
No, that's a car. It's an Italian
car. The next game on my list here is one that I've actually never heard of. Rabbids Invasion.
Okay.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Yeah, it's going to be on the 360, the Xbox One, and the PS4, and it's released November 6th. And Just Dance 2015 is going to be released on all consoles on the 23rd of October.
What console?
All of them.
Okay.
Yep. All right, Battlefield 4 Premium Edition is Xbox One, PS4, and PC going to be released on the 24th of October. Dragon Age Inquisition? Dragon Age Inquisition.
Yeah.
I'm Batman.
Yeah. November 21st. And then there's a game here that hasn't had too many headlines yet. Battlefield Hardline.
Yes, Battlefield Hardline.
Yeah.
What's that?
It's a new Battlefield game, and we haven't got an actual date. We've just got it's going to be released in the fourth quarter of 2015.
To be confirmed.
Yep.
Sometime for Christmas next year.
Disney, whole bunch of Disney stuff coming out November 6th.
What are some of the games?
All the Disney Infinity stuff, the Toy Box combo, the Hulk single figure. They're all just figures to add on.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So in the Quirk Log, what's the next one? Okay, last list of games. Mm. This is Sega and Telltale Games. Walking Dead Season 2 is going to be released on October the 31st. Wolf Among Us is going to be released on everything 7th of November. Football Manager, 7th of November. Company of Heroes 2, 18th of November. One I can't pronounce. Hatsune Miku?
Yes, usual spelling.
Yep. 20th of November. And 14th of November, Persona 4 Arena Ultimax. And I don't even know these games.
Persona.
Yeah.
I've got one.
Also, just before I let you carry on there.
Yeah.
Fid's going to update all these release dates. He's going to pop a nice little thing on hashtagme.co.nz with the dates of the games.
Thanks, bro. Look at the way you're grinning at me as you say this.
Because who's going to remember all these things that you've just read out?
I know, right? This is a good point.
Yeah.
And there's a whole bunch of Turtle Beach stuff, which is quite exciting for the online gamers.
PlayStation 4 released at E3 news that they were remastering a game called Grim Fandango for the PS4.
Grim Fandango?
Yeah.
I've never heard of it.
Yeah.
It's a PlayStation game.
Yeah.
Pretty cool game. And apparently the remastered version is amazing. So people have been playing it at Comic-Con.
Okay.
And that's currently the bigger buzz at the moment, is the remastered version for PlayStation 4.
Fantastic.
Grim Fandango.
Talking about Comic-Con New York City, they were doing something a bit interesting with Snapchat. If you've got the Snapchat app, you had no choice but to be getting a feed from Comic-Con New York City 2014.
True.
Yeah, it just showed up in my timeline. I've just been getting updates from it all day. Nothing exciting either, to be honest. It's a bit of a weird marketing thing.
Yeah.
So they just put up images or videos of people walking around?
Yeah, well, that and just...
Yeah, look, here's a comic book nerd.
The same sort of stuff you would have seen on Instagram if you looked up the hashtag.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Now, we're getting close to the end of the show.
Yes, we are.
But something interesting happened this week on... Well, I was going to say on Twitter, but it sort of started in the podcast world.
Okay.
We had a shout-out on another podcast.
Okay.
Go us.
Yeah. The Podfellas. The Podfellas, they're a New Zealand podcast network. Another podcast network.
Oh, no, they're not those big mints.
No. They're not the big mints.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. They've got a couple of good podcasts out there, and the particular podcast was Kneel Before Pod.
Yep.
They did a special episode from Yubi, and Yubi mentioned that they sponsor us.
Hi.
Yeah. You can check out Yubi at TR with a bass. But they went into this weird tirade about how they were going to do a dance for us.
A dance?
Yeah.
Have they done this so-called dance for us?
No, they haven't.
Who's doing the dance? Yubi?
No.
Oh.
Podfellas. Yeah. I have no idea, like, what they were getting at about dancing for us. Is it some sort of mating ritual?
I don't know.
I really have no idea.
But I feel like, are we about to have a dance-off?
Well, that's what I was starting to get worried about. Is this a dance-off? Are we going to have to pull out our secret weapon of Carice McAwesome?
Yeah.
Who I have seen you dancing in the club.
That's how I attracted you.
Yep.
Up in the club.
Yeah, up in the club.
Yeah. So we're going to have to pull out our secret weapon for this dance-off? Or?
Yeah.
Is this a dance-off?
I don't know, but I can twerk better than Miley. Just saying, just putting it out there.
Just saying.
Old school style.
We'll post a video of that up later.
Yeah.
So we need confirmation from the Podfellas. What's going on here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you challenging us? Are we going to have to throw down?
Throw down a dance?
Yeah, are we going to have to throw down, y'all?
Yeah.
You've been served.
Apparently there's a party at mine.
It's a retro party by the looks of it, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
Podfellas.com. Yeah. Check them out anyway.
I do know that they are going to be at Armageddon the same weekend as us.
So is that where we're having our dance-off?
Well, this is what I'm wondering. Are we going to have to throw down at this dance-off there? Or is this going to be like Clash of the Podstars?
Clash of the Podstars? Who are the Podstars?
I don't know. We're on the radio right now.
Yeah, we are. So
we're a step above.
Yeah. I reckon we'll go for a quick break and then we'll come back and wind up the show. What do you reckon?
Follow them on Twitter, though. They're at Podfellas.
Yeah.
And have a look at podfellas.com because we are in the same game and we support New Zealand broadcasters and podcasters.
Yeah,
and,
definitely.
And everything that encompasses. Yep. So check them out.
Awesome. Now, our next track is going to be dedicated to them. And it's some Tay Tay.
Some
tea swizzle. You're on hashtag.
I go on too many dates, but
And the haters gonna hate, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake. Shake it off, shake it off. Heartbreakers gonna break, 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 break. And the fakers gonna fake, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake.
The wrong neighbours.
Because the right neighbours is
Neighbours of Norton.
With me, Constable Willie Covers.
And me, Yona Manu. Together we'll tell you how to prevent crime in your area.
And give you the burglary statistics in West Hamilton.
Find out how to keep your home and neighbourhood safe. Listen to Neighbours of Norton Friday mornings at 11 on Free FM 89.0.
Hashtag Radio NZ.
You're back with Hashtag, and I think we just offended somebody's eyeballs with an Instagram account. Without Instagram?
Yeah.
We're brought to you by UBI. You can check them out at ubi.com, on Twitter at UBNZ, Facebook, and also down at Te Awa, the base, for all your Apple goodness.
Yes, they're the only authorised Apple reseller and service provider
in New Zealand, isn't it?
Yeah,
pretty sure.
Okay,
we'll pretty sure. We'll go with that. We'll go with that. Anyway, it's getting very close to the end of the show. We've got heaps of articles up this week as well, on hashtagme.co.nz, as well as a few new podcasts.
Yes, we've got the Hashtag Me podcast network. So check out Bits of Awesome, mm-hmm. and Access Granted.
Yeah, there's a new Bits of Awesome up this week as well, which is the top five games of all time.
According to a couple of idiots.
Yeah, exactly. and Access Granted goes up every single week, and it's our mates Raj and Mike down in Wellington. They're talking to people inside the industry of tech and ICT.
Yeah, they're a bit more serious than us.
Yeah.
But still... fairly easygoing.
Yeah, easygoing. Informative show, that one. It's good, yeah. Good sort of hearing what's going on inside the industry as opposed to our sort of look from the outside.
Yeah, we're kind of end user, they're a bit more involved. But yeah. Certainly worth a listen. They've interviewed some awesome people along the way as well so far.
Yep. And, Chris, what's happening with Hashtag TV?
It's going well.
Do we know when's it going out? What's happening?
I can't say exactly when it's going out.
Yeah.
I can tell you that we've got something like 460 minutes worth of footage to get through.
Yeah.
For a 110-minute series.
Yeah.
Awesome.
It's going to be a while.
So it's still,
and I'm still adding on content.
Yeah.
Still a couple of weeks away before we get a taste going up on YouTube? Or?
As a taste, yeah. About 3 weeks away.
Yeah.
Awesome. I'm looking forward to that.
And we're going to be filming some more at Armageddon. So if you're at Armageddon, make sure you check us out. And we're going to have tickets to give away to Armageddon too.
Yeah, for Armageddon Auckland.
Yeah. And that's us for another week.
Yeah, we're all done.
We are all done.
And we're out of time. Silence.
Silence. I'm just queuing up our big outro because we've got to do this shiz properly. All anyway, right. Thanks to UB, thanks to Free FM, and we will see you next week.
See you.
#me.co.nz
For more episodes of this Community Access Radio show, please visit freefm.org.nz.
Thanks to New Zealand On Air for making this program available through funding the Access Internet Radio Project. Cheers, New Zealand On Air.